Hi there. I'm Luke Victor, one of the Maptek Edinburgh office's mining engineers. There's a lot of different ways to create data in Vulcan, and today I'm going to show you a few of the lesser known ways to make new points fit to existing data. On screen you can see some data which I've borrowed from one of our online training courses. You can see a pit shell and ramp strings are loaded, and the first tool I'll be using today is the track section tool. This one is very useful when designing pit shells which share walls, as it allows you to make new data identical to existing lines. You could also use it for snapping to an exclusion zone or a drive center line or a section of an ore body. So to use this tool, you can simply start digitizing some data. And select the track section of existing line option at the bottom of the screen here. On the first click, it selects the object, and you can see it highlights how far around the object you've selected. When you next left click, it exits the track section, and you can see that it's copied every point along that line that I had selected. The next trick I want to show to you today is the gradient feature. In our training courses, we go over a few ways to create data at a gradient, or modify the gradient of a line after it's been created. One of the easiest ways to create a line on a gradient is the grad box next to the Z and W boxes in the status toolbar. You can see it's set to its default value at the moment of 0 to 1. I could set that to -1 to 11.5, and we'd create a ramp going downwards. So by creating a simple line and snapping using snap to objects to somewhere at the toe of this wall, and then indicating the X and Y locations that I want the ramp to be created at, Vulcan will automatically generate the ramp going downwards. When I rotate the view so that we can see what has been created, you can see that it's generated a ramp coming down alongside the ore body. Up next is the Smart Snap feature, which is great for design data that needs to interact with existing lines or polygons. By right-clicking on the Smart Snap option, you can see that I get a bunch of options that I can use for snapping. In the interest of keeping the video short, I'll just cover a couple of these. First one of these tools that I want to show today is the parallel tool. As the name suggests, it's for creating lines which are parallel to existing data. So I can select a single point, and then by mousing over any other line, you'll see it snaps to the same direction as that line, and I'm not able to accidentally create data that's not parallel to that. So if I create a point here, and then I can snap to a different line and create another parallel point, or if I accidentally snap to the wrong one, I can right-click and then pick a different line. Now, as an alternative to parallel data, you might be interested in data that's extrapolated from an existing line. So I'll also show you apparent intersection. So what this allows you to do is, if I pick a couple of points here and pick a line that I wanted to extrapolate out from, and actually create points that would have been on that line, but are outside of the extent of that line. You can see it's snapping onto imaginary parts of the line that were never drawn. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I'm Luke Victor, Technical Services Mining Engineer at Maptek Edinburgh, and this has been some of the advanced snapping modes in Vulcan. These tips are just a few small examples of what's included in many of our introductory and refresher training courses, which are available both online and in person. We run these courses throughout the year across the world. To find out about courses near you or online training, check out the link in the description. Thanks for watching.